Hello.
Oh, this is so nice in here.
Hi, horsey. Woo, even this is electric.
It's too slow, I'm sorry. I'm gunning it. But it's not.
Ah, it does work.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we've got a Mercedes-Benz S450 4MATIC. And that means that it has the all-new inline six mild hybrid 48 volt EQ boost system, drivetrain, and well, to be honest, we drove the CLS 450, and that drivetrain, although it's not super impressive power wise, it is super impressive smoothness wise. It is so deliciously fluid and supple. So I thought, well, what would that be like in an S-Class? The sort of pinnacle of serenity. So we've got an anthracite blue one. You might not see it because it is very gray out today, but there is some blue in there, some dark gray, really beautiful. 20 inch multi-spoke AMG wheels. We've got tinted windows at the rear, and we've actually got, ladies and gentlemen, some real exhaust tips in there. Yes, with a valve even. Yay, well done Mercedes. So we will start in the back because we've got a beautifully specced interior, and I already feel guilty for getting in this car with my dirty shoes with these light colored floor mats. But oh, this is so nice in here. I know I've shown you this before, but it's so lovely. As you can see, we've got this light interior with dark brown and contrast piping in some spots. We've got this diamond shape leather, perforated leather. We've got ash wood with an open pore so you can actually feel stuff. We've got a Burmester audio system, which is part of the Premium Package Plus or Premium Plus Package, whatever. Some entertainment, two screens, 12 volts, your climate stuff is on there, and oh, we can actually also change some stuff. So we can actually change the ambient lighting from here, which I didn't know, but it's not. Ah, it does work. As you can see, I will show you when we go underneath the tunnel over there, when we cross the highway. This is so nice, this ambient lighting. I know it sort of looks like it's too much on video, but if you're driving it on a day like this, when it's so gray and dreary outside, it's actually really nice to have that ambient lighting. At night, I don't really like it because it's too bright, so I always put it at like, well, 10% or something like that. But on a day like this, it's actually really nice, and I didn't really know that. I sort of discovered that today. I'll get that going. We also got this super nice seat setup, so it has like contour seats, which is an option, with these very thick seat belts, belt bag, it says on here, which means that there are airbags inside this seat belt, which is pretty cool. We've got these nice pillows, which are super soft. The seats are adjustable, so you can get your super relaxed mode on, and you can also select this one. Not right now. Yes, so I can adjust this seat in front of me, which is pretty nice as well. If you put it all the way forward, you've got loads of space. And we've also got this center thing with a cubby, an HDMI port, two USB ports, and some cup holders with a very smart cover. I don't really like that they put these rubber thingies on, but that's for grip, of course. But still, it's nice that they put in the effort to cover the cup holders up. Woo, even this is electric. Check that out.
You really don't have to do anything, because this also has sort of a soft, you can just let it go. Nice. And we've got these blinds all the way around, and we can close these ones up, or this one. We've got a little mirror up there, so if you're going to a gala or something, you can use this. Hello. And clothes hanger, some reading lights. Yes, it is a very, very nice place to be. It is so luxurious and opulent. It feels like you're in something special, which of course is a good thing if you pay this amount of money for a car. So let's get in. And up front we've got more of this super light stuff. So light leather steering wheel, beigey. Hi Horsey. He's staring at me like, dude, what kind of car is that? It's an S450 4MATIC. 367 horsepower, buddy. Yeah? Oh, I offended him, I think. Plus 22 electric horsepowers. Bye. And as I said, we've got this nice leather with diamond pattern. But what's really nice is that this is hard, but this is soft. So you can actually push this. I love to push stuff to see how soft it is and to see, you know, what they have done to make it nice and squishy. Like these headrests, which are really soft, and they are also adjustable. So I can see it's completely adjustable. This is for the chauffeur mode. I don't want it all the way. Ah, there it goes. So everything is electric, everything is really nice, but we also have to take a look at the engine, because as I just told the horse, we've got 367 horsepower and 500 newton meters from this inline six bi-turbo engine, and it also has 22 horsepower and 250 newton meters from the EQ Boost electric motor, which I've told you a lot about in the past. So why don't we link the CLS 450 POV review up here in the top right corner. You can check that out for a more comprehensive review of this powertrain. But for now we're just going to get in, see how this S-Class handles with this powertrain, and well, see what it's like on the Autobahn. So let's buckle up. Oh, we don't have the belt bag in here, just for the rear passengers. The important people get one. And we'll start it up. There it goes. As you know, or maybe you don't know because you haven't seen the other videos, it has an electronic starter alternator. It's called an ISG, integrated starter generator, which is also the starter motor. So you don't hear anything, it just starts. And that also means that when you're in eco mode, you get this coast mode where the engine just turns off altogether. And we will also get rid of these dials because I don't really like them. We'll go for the classic. This S450 is the base model right now, and of course you can't help but compare it to the S560 we have also driven, which has the V8 4-liter biturbo engine, which has been downtuned a bit. You know, it's the same engine that is in the C63 AMG, and that one has a lot of effortless performance, a lot of effortless power. Of course it has a V8 soundtrack, but maybe, just maybe, that this drivetrain with that, all that quiet stuff and the smoothness, might just be a better fit for the S-Class. Because this car is ridiculously comfortable. I've got it in comfort mode right now. Let's go to Eco. I can show you the coasting as well. So we're coasting. Let go of the throttle and the engine turns off altogether and we're coasting. So we've seen this in a lot of Mercedes cars and AMG cars as well, because the E53 also had this, but it works really well because it's seamless. The transition is seamless and it just means that it becomes a bit more efficient and, well, in the case of an S-Class, it also becomes a lot more comfortable actually, because all this quiet stuff, this seamless stuff is good for an S-Class. You want that. So as I promised, we are going to go for the ambient lighting in the little tunnel, so I can show you how cool it looks. Actually, don't see that much right now. It's on glacier blue, that's why. So we'll go for ocean blue. This is by far the brightest one. And as you can see, it lights up the interior. But it's very cool because it's indirect light. So it shines from underneath the dashboard down. So this is all lighted up. Your foot, the footwell is lighted up. The door is lighted up. Behind the screens is some lighting. And, well, if we change color, you can see that you can get multiple colors as well. But these brighter colors, the purple, the red and the blue, are actually quite visible in the daylight, which, you know, as I said, it's nice. It just, it gives you this cozy feeling in here, because you have this light interior with this light headliner and all this lighting going on. It just feels like a very cozy and comfortable place. It's like the modern version of sitting by the fireplace. And of course, this car has the star up front, which gives you an almighty feeling of being the top dog on the road. So we'll get a digital speedometer going now as we are approaching the autobahn. And you will notice, again, we will test the smoothness. So why don't we do it a bit differently? Normally I just floor it and see what happens and how far I can get. But why don't we go for a little cruise of a couple of minutes at 200 kilometers an hour, if the traffic allows for that. Because it demonstrates how comfy and just smooth all around this car is. Of course, the comfortable suspension does mean that you trade off on handling, because it is very wobbly and it sometimes gets a bit unbalanced when you get a couple of bumps and camber changes following each other up. But overall, it is just very cloudy and comfortable. So we'll get up to 200 kilometers an hour. And again, this powertrain is not the most powerful one, but it does impress with its smoothness. You just don't really notice it's there. And the speedometer shows that you're actually going quite quickly, but you don't really feel that. So this is cruising speed, 200 kilometers an hour. It's still very quiet, it's still very composed. You don't really hear that engine. And this car actually makes 200 feel like 120. Okay, it's too slow, I'm sorry, I'm gunning it. Sport! So let's see. I still can't hear that engine actually. You have to really try to find it. So, as I said, it is quite quick, 250 already. And that's the limiter, 258. Still super nice, super comfortable. Of course, we've got a little more wind and tire noise at this speed, but it's still very comfortable. So the top speed, as you just saw, 250 kilometers an hour limited, 0 to 100 kilometers an hour, 4.9 seconds, which is actually pretty quick. But that's of course because it has 4MATIC and that electric boost, which just goes from a standstill. The only problem is we weren't able to get that 4.9. We measured on our draggy 5.4. We did it like 7 times and that was the quickest. So don't really know what's up. It was a bit wet, but we didn't have any traction problem, so I don't know. 5.4 is still pretty quick for a car this size and for the base model. Here we go. Little engine note there of that 6-cylinder. If you look at the competition, BMW 740i also has a 6-cylinder, and the Lexus LS500H hybrid also 6-cylinder. If I have to compare this to those two competitors, I would say that, you know, we've made an whole review about the 7 Series recently. That is really the driver's car. That is a car that you can put in sport and still feel like you're in charge. You're driving it and the car appreciates you throwing it around, even though it is a 7 Series. That car is super impressive handling wise. This car is much more about the comfort, about the quietness, the smoothness, the opulent feel you get when you sit in here with all this beautiful flowing interior design, all this leather. The finishing on this car is spot on. It is beautiful. It might be the best of all of them. And the Lexus, well, the Lexus is a bit weird. The Lexus is for people who want to drive something different. It is super impressive on all fronts, that Lexus, apart from the drivetrain, which just feels like it's 10 years old, which it is. So that Lexus sort of limps behind, and well, they're all chasing the Audi A8 55 TFSI if it comes to technology and if it comes to just feeling like a car of the present, of the future. So if you ask me, it comes down to your personal preference. Do you want something that drives well, that handles well when you want it? Do you want something that's super, a bit old world, comfortable and chic like this one? Or do you want something that's super modern and high tech like the Audi? That kind of sums it up for the German 3. And if you want to have the old ball, you go for the Lexus, which I'm not, you know, I do recommend driving the Lexus if you're looking for a car like this, because it is exquisite, but the drivetrain is a bit old. All right, well, we're back in the Netherlands, so that means the fun is over. And that also means I'm going to end the POV review. Thanks so much for watching. You can also check out this POV review of an S63. You can check out this POV review playlist, and you can subscribe by clicking the big button right here. Don't forget to hit the bell for notifications to receive a notification when we upload a video, and follow us on social media. Just search for AutoTopNL. Thanks guys, see you at the next one. Bye.